Hello everybody, and welcome to a new IBMI RPG sample video. Today, I'd like to show you an example of how we can improve a simple process in our system just using activation groups and the static keyword. Let's go. Before starting, let me tell you that the programs that I'm going to show you in this example are very simple, but for a small demonstration, they are enough. Well, let me first of all show you the initial process that I have made. Is this one? Well, as you see, the process is just a CL program. I'm going to run this program in batch. The CL has a loop that will be running 5 times, and after that, it will end. In every loop, the CL is calling 3 times to a program, and it is making a delay of 5 seconds. It's as simple as this. Let me show you now the program source that the CL is calling 3 times. Test CLV P1. Okay, let me see. Is this one? Well, as you see, it is a very simple program. It is reading all the records of a file to know how many records it has. The program is a non-cycle program, as you see, with the file declared into the main procedure. Also, we can see here that the program runs into the default activation group. Okay, so what happens in every program call? Well, as it is defined, the program starts running the main procedure. Then the file is open, it is processed, and after that, it is closed. And as the CL is gonna call it 3 times in every loop, and I have 5 loops to run, it will be called 15 times. Sometimes we don't think on these things when we are developing, and these are important things. So it is clear that the process can be improved. Okay, how we can do it? Well, the main goal is improving the number of times the file is being opened. Now the process is opening the file 15 times, and we can improve it to be open just 1. To do that, I'm gonna change the CL program to make it ILE. So let's close this. And first of all, let me copy this process, copy member. We're gonna put it into the CLLE source file, and it is going to be named as CL process 2. Okay. And well, let me declare the activation group in where the program is gonna run. It is done this way. Okay. In this case, as we want the files to keep open, we should use a name 1. And as the program is gonna be run in batch, we don't need to close the files. The system will do it when the job ends. So we don't need to use a new activation group in this case. Remember this, because if we call the program directly, not in batch, the files will be open at the end, and then we will need to close the job with a sign-off, or we can reclaim the activation group to close the files. But if we want to run the process again, it will be fine because the process will not need to open the files again. So it depends on how you want it to be run. You will need to change the options, okay? Well, let me compile this program as a bound CL program. And now let's change the RPG source. Okay, let me change this. I'm gonna use a different program. Okay, let me compile it again. Okay, so let me open the file, the program source, and we are going to copy this to a new one to make the change, the changes. Okay. What I'm gonna do is first of all changing the RPG program to be run into the Corer activation group, defined in this case by the CL program. Remember that if the CL is compiled with a named activation group, the RPG program will run in the named activation group too. And this is done this way. Okay. Well, as the file is declared into the main procedure, as you see here, by default, it will be open and closed in every call. So we want it to keep open. So for changing this, we have two different options. The first is changing how we declare the file. We can declare it globally, okay? But this is not the better option. If we work with procedures, the better option is always declaring the files inside the procedures, because a procedure should be as encapsulated as possible. Always taking care about how many times the procedure is gonna be called. We don't want to open a file more than once, okay? Well, the second option is better, I think. I only need to declare the file as static, this way. So, this way, the program will open the file in the first procedure call, and it will keep the file open until the activation group ends. So let's do it this way. Let's compile it. Okay. So that's it. The process has been improved, and it will run without all that open operations. So as you can see, this is a very simple example of how we can improve our processes, reducing the number of times we open files. This is a very expensive operation, and we should use it as less as possible. I hope you liked this video. Press the like button in that case, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching.